Hey, it's Zara. In this video, I'm going to do a few examples of integrals that at first look difficult, but are actually really easy once you know a few basic tricks. And if you stick to the end of the video, I will also show you an example of an integral that might look easy at first, but is actually hard to integrate using regular methods. So let's get right into it. So here's the first example. We can see that we have some trig here with the sine, and we also have a composite function here as well. And seeing this is an indication that substitution might come in handy. The integration by substitution method allows us to change the variable of integration so that the integrand, or that the function that's being integrated, is integrated in an easier manner. So in this example, we can define a new variable, let's call it z. And we can define z to be this inner part here. So now we can take the derivative on both sides with respect to x. And after taking the derivative and with a little bit of algebra, we get that 2x dx is equal to dz. And now we can substitute this back into our original function. Now, this looks a lot easier to solve, doesn't it? And all that's left to do is remember the trig identity for the integral of sine. I remember it because of a little trick that I came up with when having to learn how to derive. When you take the derivative of sine, the sine stays the same. And when you take the derivative of cosine, the sine changes. So I remember sine and same and cosine and change. So when you integrate, it's the opposite. Or you can also remember it based on the Taylor expansion. I can discuss this at length in another video if you would like, just let me know in the comments. So basically, the integral of sine is negative cosine. And I know you might forget the plus c, so don't forget that. And to get the final answer for this integral, we just have to plug back in the c that we substituted, and that will give us the final result. And there you have it. Now on to the second example. The first thing we can notice about this function is that it is an improper rational function. This just means that the degree of the numerator is greater than or equal to the degree of the denominator. Knowing this, we can use long division to simplify the expression. Essentially, what we are trying to do is that we want to split the numerator into two parts with the hope that the fraction will be simplified with integration. We can divide the numerator by the denominator to get the following. We can see that this expression is identical to the original function, but now it's much simpler to integrate. Let's next factor out the denominator, and we can see that x equals 2 and x equals 3 are the roots. So now that I factored the denominator, I just plugged it back into the original function. Furthermore, we can put aside this one for now, and we can split this fraction into a sum of two fractions. And I'm able to do this because recall that when we want to add two fractions, we need to have a common denominator. So we'll eventually end up with what we originally had. Now we just need to find out what a and b are. And remember, these are just constants. We can find a and b by comparing the two sides of the equation, giving us a very simple system of equations. And you can solve the system of equations by elimination, or if you are a fan of linear algebra, then you can solve it with matrix inversion. And we can very easily see that a is equal to minus 5 and b is equal to 10. Now, putting everything together, we can see that this is a very simple integral to solve. We can split it up into three separate integrals and then just combine the results. I'll also pull out the constants just to make it clear where this is going. Now that I've split up the integral, I also wanted to remind you of the reciprocal rule, which I have written up here. When you take the integral of 1 over x dx, you get the natural logarithm of x plus c. And we can apply that rule here for the second and third integrals. The first integral is very easy. The integral of 1 is just x. and then we can apply the reciprocal rules to the second and third integrals. And this is our final result. I hope that wasn't too difficult to follow. These were examples of problems that don't look so easy to solve at first, but with a couple of tricks turned out to be really simple. I want to also mention integrals that look easy to solve, but are actually quite complex. This brings me to my third and final example. This integral at first looks very innocent, but it actually cannot be solved in closed form. By the way, this integral is related to the Gaussian distribution. And despite its seemingly straightforward form, there is no elementary function that represents its integral. However, we can use numerical methods to integrate this, which can be easily done if we use the Taylor expansion. So, for example, I can rewrite this integral as follows. So, this is an approximation which we can get by integrating the polynomial terms from its Taylor expansion. The big O notation means the order of the function within parentheses. In other words, if we just approximate the integral with the first three terms, then the error of this function will be on the order of x to the sixth. So this is not as straightforward as it looks. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you ever come across a problem that looks difficult, just remember that it might not be as difficult as you think. It could be really simple by remembering a few simple tricks, or it could be more difficult than that.